morning. Thank you for starting your day with Good Day Charlotte.
When it comes to the preparing for the holidays, you need to think about everyone in the family, Paige.
Which also, of course, means your furry members at home. We're talking pet preparedness when we come back. Well, the holidays, folks, are almost here, and if you have pets, you probably already know they can ruin the holidays in some ways. You don't want them to ruin it for you, and you don't want theirs to be ruined, of course, right? So let's get those dogs, cats, and your guests ready. Joining us today, host of the syndicated radio show, The Pet Buzz, Miss Charlotte Reed, with her dog, Tyne, a.k.a. Tyne the Tongue, who is the cutest little pup around, dressed like a turkey this morning. Oh, my goodness, he's precious. Charlotte, you have some good tips. You are a pet trendologist, I should say. So you have your eye on all of what's out there with
all the trends, the best products, seasonal tips, and of course, money-saving advice, because you know as a pet owner, we need to save money.
Yes, we do. And we need to keep our pets happy and safe around the holidays.
Absolutely,
too, right?
Because, you know, really, think about it like this way. If you take the extra step now, you don't have to worry about putting a dent in your wallet before Christmas if something happens. So let's start out with dress to impress. While everyone can see that, Tyne the Tongue is dressed like a turkey. So we love costumes. We think they're great fun, and they also make great family pictures.
Uh-huh.
Now, Phyllis, your dog, she's not a costume wearer.
I don't know. You know, I haven't tried her in one. I don't really know how to start, like to check and see if she would be okay with it.
The best thing to do is start with, like, a really nice seasonal bandana, and you can get something like that for, like, less than $5, and it says thanks or give thanks. And, you know, the nice thing about costumes or bandanas, it's great for the holiday family photos. You know, it kind of draws the dog in the center, and everyone's there. You know, maybe the ugly, if you wear ugly sweaters, it's kind of the same thing. But it's just a nice little draw. It makes everyone smile.
You know, and if you have kids, exactly, it's going to make them laugh and be in a better mood about the picture, too. Okay, you sent over some tips here, so let's go through them. Number one here, you said to stock up on the essentials, which is a good tip I wouldn't have necessarily thought of, and I guess that's the whole idea, right?
Well, you know, we all get so busy around the holidays, so I always say, go out, get all the litter, get all the food, everything that you need, because parties come up, things happen at the last minute, and you don't want to run out of any, especially pet owner products, especially because, you know, during the holidays, people always stop by. Now, one of the great tips for that is Black Friday sales at the local pet store. Sometimes the big box stores have food, litter, and odor eliminator on sale. And then, of course, Amazon. Don't forget that.
What a great idea. And I hadn't thought either. You mentioned air filters, which is a great idea to sort of keep things fresh, especially if you've got people coming into your home, A, who may not be used to your pets, and B, might be bringing their own pets, too.
Well, it's always a good idea to talk to everyone before they come that you have a pet. This way, allergy sufferers can decide if they want to come, if they need to take more medication. Now, if you have cats, for example, six times as many people... People are allergic to cats six times as many as dogs. So there are more people who have cat allergies than anything else. But, you know, I mean, realistically, and then once you get guests to your house, remind them, don't open the windows, don't open the doors, because your pet's inside. And pets can very easily DoorDash when we have the holidays with so much holiday hubbub. So that's why you need to create a retreat for them.
Which is a great tip also.
I know you were just about to say that.
I was actually, listen, I read your notes ahead of time, because your pet may enjoy part of it, but you kind of need to let them have a place to get away to themselves too, right?
Exactly. Well, I think, how many dogs do you have?
Just the one.
So
for
I
now.
Have six.
I know.
No, I'm sorry. I have seven.
Right? Yeah.
I have seven and a cat and a bird.
Okay.
So my boyfriend's a vet. So we have tons of animals. But the most important thing is if you have that retreat, they can go into the room and they can choose to be involved if not. But make sure you have food and water and, you know, treats. Maybe play some soft music, especially when the football starts.
Right.
Okay. Last but not least, you want to have some bright colored bowls, because when you have too many people in the kitchen, somebody will kick
Someone's
over the water
gonna
bowl.
Sip on it.
And also, one of the other things I really like to do to freshen in the house, and this is my last tip, is nice dog pillows, because the National Dog Show airs between the parade.
True.
So everybody at my house, and there's so many people that we have for Thanksgiving, we have breed pillows for everyone, and it makes a nice holiday gift.
What a fun idea. You are just full of cute ideas. Charlotte Reed, listen, you can follow along with Charlotte, the pet trendologist, the Pet Buzz radio show. Keep a listen out for that, and follow along with Tyne the Tongue also. Thank you so much for coming in. Guys, take a quick break. We'll come back in 2 minutes. Like that.